So Anna is the chief strategy officer of the city of New York. And in this role, she is responsible for investments fund, for partnerships, for the incubators, accelerators in the city. And more than that, for the whole big project the city is responsible for in cybersecurity, life science, artificial intelligence, and so on and so on. And the EDC itself will be happy to hear from you what is the role itself of the New York Economic Development Corporation and how it works, what is the focus. Before that, I will just mention an interesting fact. The number of people in New York City is 8.6 million. The number of people in Israel is 8.7 million. It's almost the same. And within a week, with all the Israelis that came to New York, I think now it's equal. So, Anna.
Thank you. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here and welcome everyone to New York City. The Economic Development Corporation is essentially the economic development arm of the city of New York. It's a 500 people organization that's financially self-sustaining with a very simple mission that is to grow jobs and support businesses here. So our mandate is jobs, and our tools and our portfolio is very broad. We manage real estate, 60 million square feet of it. We invest in big infrastructure projects, and we make investments in strategic sectors for the economy. And so at any given time, we have a diversity of projects. Right now, for example, we are running a transit system, a ferry system called NYC Ferry on the East River. We are building a contiguous pedestrian path around Manhattan's waterfront. We are opening a tech training center in Union Square. We are making investments in cybersecurity and biotech and redeveloping neighborhoods across the city. It's all about attracting talent, retaining talent, and supporting businesses. I'm in charge of the industry portfolio and the innovation portfolio, and over the last 10 years, we've been making very intentional investments to support the growth of tech and innovation in the city. We have led flagship projects like the new engineering campus on Roosevelt Island, which is a partnership between the Technion and Cornell. I think it's that intentional strategy is paying off. We have 9,000 startups and closed 2018 with $14 billion in venture capital investment going to New York City-based companies.
Amazing. So you mentioned 9,000 startups. Around 5% of them, 450 of them, are Israeli startups. And the number, I would say, keeps growing every month.
Yeah.
Why entrepreneurs, startups, choose New York? Not even only the Israelis, but we see a growth of startups coming to New York as opposed to, you know, compared to Silicon Valley and other places. New York became, I think, in the last few years, like the main hub for startups, technology startups from Europe, mainly from Israel, and so on.
Yeah, I think that's a great question, and there's a number of reasons. I'll start with one thing that differentiates New York City from almost every other city in the world, which is our scale and the diversity of industries that we have here. So what entrepreneurs are doing here is solving problems for the industries that we have here. And if you look at companies that are valued over $1 billion in New York City, they're in finance, they're in media, they're in medicine, they're in real estate, they're in fashion. And so we're leaning into our existing industries to support that growth. And the investments that you mentioned that we're making in blockchain, in cybersecurity, biotech, AR, VR, are well positioned because it's those industries driving demand for those products and services. And so I think the one reason is, you know, is the customers are here, right? We have, you talked about the scale of New York City. Our metro GDP is $1.4 trillion, which is larger than South Korea's. We have more Fortune 500 companies than any other city in the US, also small and medium businesses. And so that's one. I think that scale translates into talent as well. We have over 120 higher ed institutions, colleges, and universities. International talent is very attracted to New York, right? And 30% of H-1B visas that are awarded in the US that were awarded in 2016 were awarded in New York City. And so we are capturing a lot of US talent, but also international talent. And then I think those things are just so unique to New York, the scale and the quality of the talent and the industries that we have here. I think there are a couple of areas in which we have come a long way in the last decade where, you know, the Valley used to, you know, kind of outperform us for a number of years, but we've come a long way now. One is investment and venture capital investment, and it used to be the case that if you were a startup here, you had to go to the West Coast, you had to go to Boston to raise funds. You know, now we have over 200 venture funds in New York City, and you can raise money for your company here. I think the tech community as well has grown a lot and has evolved over the years. If you go to digital.nyc, which is a one-stop shop for all things tech, you'll see there's over 100 events happening in New York City every week. Because of the scale here, it's still important to, it's very important to have events like this that are actually connecting people and bringing them together. New York Tech Meetup started with 30 people in their first meeting, and now their membership is over 59,000 people. And so the tech community has grown substantially. You know, and then think one last thought, particularly, you know, for Israelis or international companies. I think New York City is the landing pad for international companies in a way that the West Coast isn't, both because it's, you know, very welcoming, but also because of our geographical location and the time difference, particularly if you're looking at European companies and, you know, and Israel, this is just a more convenient place to be.
Right. So you mentioned all the projects that you are working on. I want to focus on one project that you in person was responsible for that, and that's the Amazon. On November 2018, it was announced that New York City was chosen out of, I think, 180 cities.
238.
Whoa, you count better than me. So to have the HQ2, the new headquarters of Amazon, and then suddenly one day it was announced that they think
they
that...
were leaving.
Yes, exactly. What happened? How did you feel? How was the process with working with Amazon?
Yeah, no, it's a great question, and you can't talk about economic development in New York City and not talk about Amazon. You know, I start by saying that it's obviously a huge disappointment, and myself and the team at EDC worked tirelessly for a year to secure the bid. I think it was a pretty grueling process over an impossible timeline. But we did it, and we would do it again because it was an unprecedented opportunity, right? It was 25,000 jobs over 10 years and up to 40,000 jobs over 25 years. So it was an incredible opportunity. And I think the fact that we won is, one, a validation that New York City has made it as a tech city, and also a validation that that we are a city that can execute on big, bold ideas. There was a lot of speculation about which city would win it, and nobody bet on New York. We were at the bottom of the list because of, you know, various reasons, perceptions of, you know, it's costly to do business in the city, but there's clearly a lot of reasons, many of which I mentioned before, why New York City is a very attractive place, and I think the fact that we won suggests that. You know, in terms of, you know, what happened, we've been, obviously we continue to reflect on what happened, but I'd say three things happened. One, there was a small but very vocal opposition, and that is not very surprising because for any major scale project in New York City, there's opposition. Every project that we engage in that, you know, that involves development and neighborhoods, there's opposition. I think what was surprising about this process specifically was the sort of misinformation and miscommunication about the facts of the deal. I think an example of that was a lot of the conversation around $3 billion in incentives and people tweeting about what to do with $3 billion of supposedly found money. That was both a misunderstanding of, first, how tax incentives work because they're foregone tax revenue on the 30, yeah, you know, billion dollars that company would have brought. And the way that the media talked about it, you know, you would not interpret that actually 2/3 of New Yorkers were in favor of the project. So even though there was broad support for the project among the elected officials and politicians at the start of the competition process, there was then, you know, kind of political headwinds that we faced. And like I said, a small vocal minority, may, you know, determining the future of New York City, which I think raises a lot of questions around how we go forward. I think a last point is that, you know, Amazon wasn't necessarily the perfect partner. I think they underestimated what it takes to do a project of that scale. And there could have been, you know, definitely more sophistication around how to engage with communities and kind of keep a pulse on the ground when you're here. So, that's a sort of a brief summary of what happened. I think it begs the question of like, what's next for New York and where do we go from here? And, I think I'm kind of over it. The fundamentals that brought Amazon here are still here. We have Facebook, Microsoft, Google, Salesforce. Amazon has 5,000 employees in the city already today. So all of the tech companies are here. They continue to grow in the city. I think the evolution of Google is an example of that. They made the biggest post-financial recession real estate purchase in 2010 when they bought 111th 8th Avenue, that building. In 2008, they bought Chelsea Market for $2.4 billion. And recently, they announced that they're leasing 2 million square feet of property across Hudson Square to accommodate the doubling of their workforce in New York from 7,000 to 14,000 over the next 10 years. So I think New York City will continue to grow strong. And from the city's perspective, we will continue to support tech and innovation.
That sounds amazing. So not only the startups, it's the whole ecosystem with the corporations, investors, and the startups. And from Amazon to another amazing project, Cyber NYC. So I would say that Cyber NYC is an initiative of came from the mayor of New York City that wanted to transform New York City to become the cyber capital of the world. And SOSA, we bid for this RFP. And a few months ago, we were happy that the city announced that SOSA was chosen out of many other entities to build and run and operate the official Global Cyber Center, which the goal is to connect the different players from the tech ecosystem, not only here, but globally, to each other. Corporations that are looking for innovation, that's what SOSA is doing, connecting them to technologies. From the other end, the startups, the technologies from all over the world, and over on top of all of that, a network of strong VCs that is part of what we are doing. What was the EDC vision in Cyber NYC? What was, why specific this sector and not other sectors? Yeah. Though you have projects in some other as well, but you focus on cyber.
Yeah, I mean, I think this effort is emblematic of our portfolio. And from an economic development perspective, it's a win-win-win. It's sort of a triple win. First, there's insatiable demand for talent in cybersecurity in New York City and globally, right? 3.5 million jobs. Projected to go unfilled by 2021. So it's a huge opportunity for people to prosper and for jobs to be created here if we have the talent that companies are looking for. Two, a big opportunity for innovation because a lot of the companies that are driving demand for cybersecurity are the same companies that I talked about at the beginning, financial services, media, healthcare, real estate, and so on. And third, we need to ensure that our industries here stay resilient, right? Support them, protect their bottom line and their reputation. And so it's a triple win. And so the initiative is an initiative that seeks to create 10,000 jobs over the next 10 years by becoming a landing pad for international companies and supporting companies that want to grow here and reach the market here in a structured way with partners like you guys. We want to support company starts, and we also want to scale enterprise-ready companies. And then we are training 10,000 people over the next 10 years, so training the next generation of cybersecurity talent that can support all of this growth. And so I think this is an example as well where New York City and Israel have a strong relationship, and I think this is an initiative where that relationship has produced tangible results, and we're very proud to have gone to Israel and seek the partnership from some of the best in the world and bring them here and help do that together.
Amazing, thank you. And last question, what is the amazing next project that you are working on that people will be happy to hear that New York City is working on that?
That people should know about?
Yeah.
We have so many projects. I think, biotech is definitely having an inflection point in the city. We've traditionally, been at the tail end of Boston and San Francisco, but it's a real inflection point. I think we have a major real estate and jobs play that we'll be announcing in the next few months that builds on a series of efforts that we've made over the years, including this building, which is on city-owned land and is one of those city-led projects to support jobs and innovation.
Amazing. Thank you, Anna.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone.